how to tune your guitar using the EVH DTuna system. You might remember this guitar from when I installed the EVH DTuna. It's been relic'd since then, and you can see there's lots of damage and so forth on the body. For this demo, I'll just go ahead and take the strap off. For most intents and purposes, if you remember the installation of the DTuna, okay, you can see here I've got the back plate off. You can see, maybe you can't, it's kind of small in there, but you see the white of the body, here's the Floyd, and then there's the brown in between. That's a piece of rosewood fingerboard, actually from a mandolin, and it just seemed to be the perfect thickness to stop the Floyd from moving. So you've got that installed, and you've got the Floyd slammed right on the body. I don't have the bar in right now. It's not a big deal. You don't need to have the bar. You can if you want, whatever. But again, for purposes of the demo, it's not going to be in there because it just isn't. So what you'll need for this to tune your guitar using the DTuna is basically the same stuff that you would need if you had a regular tuning system like just the Floyd. You're going to need an Allen wrench to unlock the nut, which is all the way up at the top. I've already done that. And then you need, obviously, a guitar pick because you want to pluck the strings. And then you need the tiny little Allen wrench that came with the DTuna, because that's how we're going to fine-tune this thing. This one will lock both the Floyd pins all the way through the bridge, and it will also lock off the nut. So I've already gone ahead and loosened the nut off. And you'll also need, obviously, a tuner. This particular guitar is tuned a full step down. So instead of tuning E to E, we're gonna tune D to D. And then with the EVH, with the DTuna out, this will go down to C. Okay, so let's take a look. You can start anywhere you like that you like to tune. Some people like to start in the middle, some people start at the high E, whatever, it doesn't matter. Today, I'm just gonna do there. So you can see, we're a little flat. Cool. And now this is the tricky part for tuning the DTuna. Once you have these strings tuned, you can leave the fine tuners probably in the middle so that you do have some play with them, okay? This last one, the E, should be all the way out. This last one now, so lock down these, and then this last one, you're gonna wanna go ahead and tune it with the DTuna plucked all the way out. So you can see here I'm quite well, okay? Good. So now that you've got that done, you're gonna take your larger Allen wrench, lock your nut down. This is good to go for your drop detuning now. It's locked into place. Take the DTuna, push down, push it into place, and now this raises it back up to your standard tuning position. This is where you're gonna take the tiny little fine tuner, and there's a tiny little nut that's set in to the DTuna here. Just place this in place. So now with the correct Allen key, pluck your string, and then you can see that you can actually put it just into this little fine tuner, and you can raise it up, or you can lower it. And there's your right spot. And then you're set and ready to go. Pretty simple, all things considered. Now, as soon as you've got everything locked into place, don't touch the fine tuner. You can if you really, really need to, like mid-song or something, something goes wonky, go ahead and crank it, but you shouldn't have to. So you're in your standard tuning, and then you drop out for your drop tuning. Super easy. Thanks for watching.